Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to our Youth and Music concert here at the Sneddon Theatre. This is our third appearance at the National Creative Youth Arts Festival, so we're very excited about that. Just to tell you a little bit about the Youth Orchestra, they are youngsters made up of performers from the age of 13 to 22, and they traverse from all around KZN province, from Richards Bay, Empangeni, Howick Hilton, Peter Maritzburg, and Durban and surrounds. Now last year, since we performed at the festival, we went to the Stellenbosch Music Arts Festival in July, and they had a wonderful tour to Germany in September, where we performed in Bremen and in Jena. And it's on the cards for us to go to China next year. So we've got a nice variety of music for you this afternoon. We're going to start out in a Renaissance mood. This first piece is by Ottino Respighi, and he was an Italian musicologist in the last century who wrote music in the Renaissance style. So our opening piece is the Belletto from the Suite No. 1. It's a transcription of lute music. And I'd like you to welcome to the stage to conduct us this afternoon, Lick Temming.
Thank you.
on to a Baroque piece by the master Johann Sebastian Bach. And this is his cantata number 208, which is also known as the birthday cantata, or more commonly as Sheep May Safely Graze. To a contemporary composer, it is Mr. Rolf Ford, who lives in the USA, in LA, and he's written this next piece. It's in a kind of movie music genre called Blunderbuss Battles. It's very evocative, so you can imagine some kind of pirate war taking place at sea with the old-fashioned arm, the blunderbuss. Here is Rolf Ford's Blunderbuss Battles.
Thank you.
now move on into the jazz genre. And in the 1950s, smaller, more experimental jazz ensembles were taking place of all the big bands of the swing era from the previous decades. And one such group was none other than the Dave Brubeck Quartet. And they started to experiment with music in different time meters. So usually music is in 3 beats or 4 beats in a bar, and they started to write music in 5 and 7 and even 13 beats in the bar. And this piece was written by their saxophonist, Paul Desmond. It's probably their most famous number. Here is Take 5. And percussion section, and we move on into the 1960s. It's a piece by Quincy Jones, and it's synonymous with the Austin Powers movies. So they're going to just move around a little bit. We're going to perform for you Soul Bossa.
Thank you.
staying in the jazz mode. We're going right back to the early roots of Dixieland jazz. This piece was written in 1914, and it goes right back to the Deep South, made famous by Louis Armstrong, and also recorded orchestrally by the Boston Pops. So we hope you enjoy our rendition of St. Louis Blues. Amongst all sorts of audiences, whether you're jazz lovers or not. And it's probably the song that was made most famous by Frank Sinatra. Please enjoy our rendition and feel free to join in if you like. New York, New York.
Thank you.
Now, a different genre of jazz is, of course, the Latin jazz. And we're going to do a piece by Pablo Beltran, recently recorded by the gorgeous Michael Bublé. Here is Sway. Piece to play for you, and bringing it back to South Africa, we're going to do a piece made famous and composed by the Soweto String Quartet, a little bit of Township Jive. Here is Zebra Crossing.